Pemphigus vulgaris, an autoimmune disorder shrouded in mystery, affects a select few, yet its impact is profound. As we delve into the depths of this condition, we'll uncover its causes, signs, and symptoms, diagnose intricacies, and various treatment modalities, and even explore home remedies that can complement medical interventions. By the way, welcome to our channel. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. Meaning of pemphigus vulgaris. Pemphigus vulgaris, dissected word by word, unveils its origin. Pemphigus traces back to the Greek word pemphix, meaning blister or bubble. Vulgaris, derived from Latin, translates to common or ordinary. Together, pemphigus vulgaris denotes a dermatological condition characterized by the formation of common blisters, or sores on the skin and mucous membranes. The juxtaposition of ancient languages paints a vivid picture of the condition's manifestation, where the ordinary takes an extraordinary form, encapsulating the essence of this autoimmune disorder in its etymology. What is pemphigus vulgaris? Pemphigus vulgaris is a rare autoimmune disorder that affects the skin and mucous membranes. In this condition, the immune system mistakenly attacks healthy cells, specifically proteins that hold skin cells together. This leads to the formation of fragile blisters that easily rupture, causing painful sores on the skin and inside the mouth. Causes of pemphigus vulgaris. Autoimmune response. Pemphigus vulgaris is primarily caused by an autoimmune response, where the immune system mistakenly attacks healthy cells, specifically the cells that hold skin layers together. Genetic factors. There may be a genetic predisposition to pemphigus vulgaris, as certain genetic factors can increase the likelihood of developing autoimmune disorders. Environmental triggers. Exposure to certain environmental factors, such as certain medications, infections, or environmental pollutants, may trigger the onset of pemphigus vulgaris in susceptible individuals. Stress. Stress is known to play a role in the exacerbation of autoimmune disorders. While it may not directly cause pemphigus vulgaris, stress can contribute to its flares and severity. Hormonal changes. Hormonal fluctuations, such as those occurring during puberty, pregnancy, or menopause, may influence the development or progression of pemphigus vulgaris. In Uyghur traditional medicine, the causes of pemphigus vulgaris are attributed to an imbalance in the body's nature and blood, allowing external pathogenic factors like dampness and heat to invade the skin's nature. These pathogenic factors disrupt the body's natural harmony and contribute to the development of pemphigus vulgaris. Treatment aims to address these imbalances and clear the pathogenic factors through herbal remedies, dietary adjustments, and external applications. Signs and symptoms of pemphigus vulgaris. Pemphigus vulgaris is characterized by the development of painful blisters and sores on the skin and mucous membranes. Here are five common symptoms associated with pemphigus vulgaris. Blisters and sores. The hallmark symptom of pemphigus vulgaris is the formation of fragile, easily ruptured blisters on the skin and mucous membranes. These blisters can occur anywhere on the body, including the mouth, throat, and genital areas. Mouth and oral lesions. Pemphigus vulgaris often presents with painful sores and blisters in the mouth, on the gums, tongue, and inside the cheeks. These oral lesions can make eating and talking challenging. Skin erosions. As the blisters break open, they can lead to widespread skin erosions, leaving raw and vulnerable areas on the skin. This can increase the risk of infection. Pain and itching. Affected individuals may experience pain, discomfort, and itching associated with the blisters and sores. The condition can significantly impact the quality of life due to the pain and potential complications. Nail changes. In some cases, pemphigus vulgaris can affect the nails, causing changes such as ridges, pitting, or even loss of nails. Diagnosis of pemphigus vulgaris. Pemphigus vulgaris is diagnosed through clinical examination, skin biopsy, and immunological tests. A dermatologist assesses blistering, confirmed by biopsy, and immunofluorescent studies detect autoantibodies. Blood tests may reveal elevated antibody levels. This comprehensive evaluation differentiates it from other conditions, guiding effective treatment for this autoimmune disorder and improving outcomes. Treatment options of pemphigus vulgaris. The treatment of pemphigus vulgaris typically involves a combination of medications to suppress the immune system and manage symptoms. Here are five common treatment options. Corticosteroids. High-dose corticosteroids like prednisone are often prescribed to control inflammation and suppress the immune response. Immunosuppressive drugs. Medications such as azathioprine, mycophenolate mofetil, or rituximab may be used to further suppress the immune system. Topical treatments. Topical corticosteroids or immunosuppressive ointments can be applied to affected areas, especially in oral lesions. Intravenous immunoglobulin may be used in severe cases to modulate the immune system. Plasmapheresis. This procedure involves removing and filtering blood plasma to remove harmful antibodies, providing temporary relief. Treatment plans are tailored to each individual, and close monitoring is essential to manage potential side effects. Early intervention improves outcomes in pemphigus vulgaris management. Natural home remedies for pemphigus vulgaris. While pemphigus vulgaris is a serious medical condition that typically requires professional medical treatment, some individuals may explore complementary approaches for symptom relief. Here are six natural suggestions that may offer some relief. Aloe vera. Applying pure aloe vera gel may soothe irritated skin and promote healing. Honey. Due to its antibacterial properties, honey can be applied topically to help prevent infection in open sores. Turmeric. Known for its anti-inflammatory properties, adding turmeric to the diet or creating a paste for topical application may have potential benefits. Oatmeal baths. Oatmeal baths can help alleviate itching and soothe the skin. Colloidal oatmeal products are available for this purpose. Coconut oil. Applying coconut oil to affected areas may help moisturize the skin and reduce discomfort. Dietary changes. Some individuals explore anti-inflammatory diets, rich in fruits, vegetables, and omega-3 fatty acids, to support overall health. It's crucial to emphasize that these natural remedies are not substitutes for medical treatment. Always consult with a healthcare professional for proper diagnosis and guidance on managing pemphigus vulgaris. Frequently asked questions about pemphigus vulgaris. Is pemphigus vulgaris contagious? No, pemphigus vulgaris is not contagious. It is an autoimmune disorder, meaning it results from the body's immune system attacking its own tissues. What are the long-term effects of pemphigus vulgaris treatment? Long-term effects vary, and while treatments aim to manage symptoms, some individuals may experience side effects. Regular monitoring by healthcare professionals is crucial. Can pemphigus vulgaris be prevented? As a genetic and autoimmune disorder, pemphigus vulgaris cannot be prevented. Early diagnosis and appropriate treatment, however, can help manage the condition. How does pemphigus vulgaris impact daily life? Pemphigus vulgaris can significantly impact daily life due to oral and skin lesions. Adaptations in diet, skincare, and emotional support are crucial for managing its effects. Thanks for watching. Take care and stay safe.